आपके वाइस प्रिंसिपल सर नवनीत कुमार जी का धन्यवाद करता हूँ. मेनी मेनी थैंक्स टू हिम. ऑल यूर चीफ पेट्रंस पेट्रंस कन्वेनर्स एंड मॉडरेटर्स. माई यंगर सिस्टर अर्चना जी, आई वेलकम यू ऑल हियर फॉर दिस फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम एंड थैंक्स ईच वन ऑफ यू फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी. द प्रोग्राम विच इज ऑर्गेनाइज बाय तीर्थंकर महावीर यूनिवर्सिटी ऑन अ वेरी वंडरफुल सब्जेक्ट. इन फैक्ट इट इज अ नीड ऑफ द आवर. That beat stress and boost happiness. The time has come after the post-COVID situation that everyone has to rethink about his happiness now. और यही happiness के तरफ मैं एक अलग तरीके से आपको लेके जाने वाला हूँ. I will be more scientific. Because I am also basically I am a paramedical, so I am feeling that I am amongst the people who are my colleagues only.
Welcome, sir.
I am also a MSc microbiologist. I have done my microbiology in 1979 from Pune University. I was invited for PhD by the Cadbury's that time. But since I have done my MSc with the bank loan, I could not go ahead with that. Then I did my PhD first PhD in geopathic stress, and the second PhD in the energy sciences when Archana ji was there.
Yes, sir.
I am sharing a presentation with you. Can you see the presentation? No, it is
visible. Yes, sir.
This is my first slide. I am taking you to some different levels today. You never thought about it actually. आपने कभी नहीं सोचा होगा कि क्या आप जहां सोते हैं वो जगह आरोग्यदायी है. Are you sleeping in a safe place? We never thought about it actually. And Vastu Arogyam is pioneer in this energy form. और ये energy को सबसे ज्यादा established करने की जो कार्य किया गया है वो Vastu Arogyam के तरफ से हमारी firm के तरफ से किया गया. आप में से कितने लोगों ने ऐसा सोचा होगा कि जो मैं सोचता हूं वहीं पे कहीं से मुझे बीमारी हो सकती है. इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस टू थिंक ऑन दिस लेवल बिकॉज नोबडी टॉट अस लाइक दिस. वी नो द इन वास्तुशास्त्र वी नो द डायरेक्शंस व्हिच आर 8 डायरेक्शंस ईस्ट वेस्ट नॉर्थ साउथ एंड आग्नेय ईशान्य नैऋत्य वायव्य. बट नोबडी टोल्ड अस दैट देयर इज समथिंग व्हिच इज कमिंग फ्रॉम बिलो द अर्थ ऑल्सो. And energy which is causing an effect on my health. Since I am from a medical background, I have worked as a CEO for many companies. I am taking you to this new medical concept since you all are from the paramedical levels. Have you ever noticed that you or someone from your near one is experiencing a health problem and strangely no one seems to have effective answer for that? This may involve unexplained pains, unexplained behaviors, unexplained conditions. You have tried many health professionals in many disciplines including traditional Yunani, alternative, allopathic, homeopathic. All medicines have been tried, but the problem remains. I And now the medical terminology, particularly in allopathy, they said that you are allergic to this. If you are getting sneezing, cough and cold very frequently, they give you many medicines, they try many things, and again the same problems will crop up after a few days. Some people have got a running nose. People, they try many things for that. Some antihistamines are being given, some other medicines are given, sometimes steroids are also given. But the moment you stop the treatment, again after a few days, same problem will come to them. And we never thought about it. We thought that, yes, if doctor is saying that we are allergic to this, then we are definitely allergic to this energy. Then we have, doctors ask us to go for finding the allergens, test of allergens. They will try many samples on you. 250 samples are tried many times to find out what are you allergic to. If we don't get any results, then with allopathy, then somebody will suggest us that you do go to Ayurveda, you go to Unani, you go to homeopathy. For chronic diseases, you get the homeopathic very well. So many things we go on trying with this type of patients. पर हमने ये देखा है हमारे फैमिली में हमारे पहचान में ऐसे कोई ना कोई आदमी जरूर है कि जिसको ये बीमारी वापस वापस होते रहती है. सेम सिम्टम्स विल कम अप. सम स्किन कंडीशंस विल कम अगेन एंड अगेन टू देम. सी एक्जिमेटस थिंग्स. Some allergical spots on the skin. And there seems that we do not have any answer. But my brothers and sister, I just want to tell you that today the solution may be here in what we are listening to it. It's very difficult for a pragmatic and educated person to understand that is there any natural rays, natural energy coming from the earth which may be harmful to oneself. It's very difficult. If I try to tell you at the initial level that there are some energy forms which are coming from below the earth and that can cause a problem to your health, then it seems to be more difficult to understand. The same thing was with me till 2005. But when I studied the entire things, I found that earth, if you go below the earth, you will find that there are running water vents, and these running water vents, when they are below 50 feet, maybe around 200 feet or any level, at any level, but when they run, they will cause a friction. Anything that is running will create an energy form. And most of the time, this energy is a static energy. Many of us have noticed this importance of static energy and its effect on us. When you go to five-star hotel and you walk on the galicha carpets and you suddenly touch to the knob of the door, which is metallic, you got a shock. It is because of the static currents which we have in body. So in Vastushastra now, even there are many books in the Western countries which are referring the earthing effect for human being now. So very well-known book also now available on earthing. You should earth yourself because the static charges are there with you. And same static charges, when water runs through their water veins, they cause a friction. And this friction will create an energy. And the law of energy says that from higher level to lower level, it will travel. So the energy which is created at below, say, 50 feet, if the water vein is at 50 feet, the energy will be created there and it will come up. If you are sleeping at the same place, if your bed is at the same place, from where the energy is coming from below the earth, for the entire night when you are sleeping, it will struck your body. It will be bombarding on your body. Your body will try to resist this energy because this is the extra form of energy which is not being required by the body, because our body also has got an aura form which is also electrostatic in nature. And this energy will one day pierce our aura. Our resistance becomes weak to this energy one day. And the moment it gets weak, then we will fall into the trap of this energy. And the symptoms will start to us. In case of running water, normally 50 to 300 feet underground, the normal vibration frequency of the earth is 7.83 hertz. But nowadays, I have got an hertz meter. And when we check at some places, we find it that it is more than 300 hertz because of the cross water vents below the earth. So much of high energy, which is a very subtle form of energy, which we do not notice, but there are animals which when they notice this, I will come to that in my presentation. The higher the energy which is emanating from below the earth in your house, the more are chances of illness in your house. In short, I can say that these are the diseases of earth energies, earth energy diseases. And this energy form is known as geopathic stress. Geo means earth, pathic means pathos or pathology, which has got an effect on your body, which can cause some diseases, some illnesses to you. So it's very important. In fact, where you are sleeping is the most important thing, because you spend the highest time of your day on your bed, about 7 to 8 hours. So the energy form should be checked where you are sleeping. The definition of geopathic stress says the energy that is emanating from the earth, which has got capacity to change the normal body functions. This energy has got an ability to change the normal body functions. Suppose you are sleeping at, say, around 10 o'clock every day. you will find those who are on geopathic stress, they will always, first level they will complain is that their sleeping cycle is always disturbed. They will go to the sleep very late in the night. Since you are all paramedicals and medical people, I can just highlight certain medical facts about it also. In our pineal gland, which is just here below our head, behind our head, just above the neck, this pineal gland secretes an hormone which is known as melatonin. And melatonin is a sleep hormone. As the biological cycle is there, your brain will give a signal to the pineal gland as per the your biological cycle that starts secreting melatonin. Once the melatonin secretion starts, slowly its concentration in the blood will increase. This is a hormone. And as the certain level of melatonin level has been achieved in your body, you will start sleeping. You will feel that you should sleep now. There will be a numbness to your fingers, to your legs, and you will start to sleep like this. Because the secretion of melatonin has attained certain level. When you are on geopathic stress, the signals are also electrostatic energy forms coming from the brain to the pineal glands, and the energy below bed, which is also a statical energy form, it will get disturbed, the signals. You will always find that there is a less of melatonin in these people. So they will go to the sleep very late in the night. The secretion is not complete. There are research, very recent studies, if you go to the some researches on melatonin now, you will find that melatonin has been linked with the tumors and also cancers now. Because melatonin acts as an night supervisor. When we all are sleeping, lakhs of our cells are being generated and lakhs of our cells are being destroyed when we are in the sleep. But in the night, there is only one supervisor to regulate the shape and size of every cell, is melatonin. It's the night supervisor. And when you have a less concentration of melatonin in your blood, less levels of melatonin will lead to dysfunctioning and dysfunctioning of a supervisory work by melatonin. So it will be a factory without the supervisor. So people will work as per their own whims and will. The same cells will get generated in the way they want. It will get mutated also in different ways. And you will find that the day will come that some sort of irregular, unwanted cells, they are in the blood. They get settled somewhere. And you will find that on some day, we diagnose it as tumor or as cancer. So there is some linkage with melatonin. I will just add to my observations that up to 100 hertz, I have seen that earth energy is well tolerated by most of the 70 to 80 hertz, most tolerated by most of the human beings. But it goes near about 100 to 150, you will find that the thyroid problems will appear in these people. If anyone is having thyroid, he can think about having geopathic stress in his house at the initial level. If it goes above 150 hertz, you will find there is a migraine. There is a first level of diabetic patients found with angiopathic stress. If it goes above that, then there is hypertension, some cardiac problem, sudden heart blocks, high level of diabetes, uncontrolled diabetes. Stroke, paralysis, Parkinsonisms, all these will follow. The moment the geopathic stress increases in your house, your body resistance get weakened, and once it is weakened, all neurological problem will start, because these are the energies which will affect your neurons. Even chronic abortions, mental retardation to a newborn, infertility problems, these are all related with geopathic stress somewhere. I have done about 400 cancer patient studies so far, and I have found that people, they do have a lot of geopathic stress, and that may be the reason why people are more prone to cancer like things. Let us come to the next. All effects of health on persons sleeping above the negative range are called as black streams. These are all geopathic stress. You can say that the gotra is geopathic stress, but there are different names given to by different people to this. Some call it as black streams, some call it as cancer rates. One physician was there who was known as an Hartman. He said that it is curry lines. He has also called it ley lines or Hartman grid. But they are all collectively known as geopathic stress. If you have a geopathic stress, your house will follow with an ill health. Next, come to this. I have told you the definition of geopathic stress. The same I have just explained here in this slide. Chinese knew about this. In fact, worldwide, when I have studied even Indian culture, if you go to Vishwakarma Prakash, which is the oldest text available for the Vastu sciences, he has a reference of geopathic stress in that. In fact, all over the world, including Chinese, geopathic stress was known 4,000 years ago to them also. All ancient civilizations in the world, around the world, they never built homes on these life-destructive lines. My studies on the old Shankara mandirs, Shiva mandirs, you can call it now. My research paper is already there on this. All these mandirs, Shiva mandirs, old Shiva mandirs I am talking about, they have been constructed in view that there is a very high geopathic zone around it. The Shiva Pinda, which is kept there, is on the cross lines of waters, winds. Very high geopathic stress zones. If you go to Trambakeshwar's, which is very near to Nasik, you will find that water is oozing out of that Shankara Pinda, Shiva Pinda. It is coming above. So there is a very high force of water which is coming above the Shiva Pinda. And these pandits, they give you this water to drink and tell you that you, this is a Godavari form, very pure water you drink. But it shows that there is a presence of water veins there. That is why this water is coming. As per the Varahamira, if you study the Varahamira, you will find that Varahamira has said that what types of veins are there in water veins. Urdhvamukhi, Adhomukhi. And these are all Urdhvamukhi veins. The water which is being flashed above. My research, I have given one very interesting statement into that. That all these Shiva Mandiras are being developed to protect the civilization and tell the people that you don't construct your houses here. You come here for some time. You do some prayers, sit there for some time. Get charge yourself with this energy. When you sit down, you are naturally, your all cells are going to be exposed to this energy. Once you are charged, you go. You cannot stay here. And there are many reasons, and I can tell you that there was a tradition, or still it is a tradition, that pandits were not allowed to sleep in the mandirs. You do night rituals, ask God to sleep, and go to your place. In the same way, it was in the afternoon also. You give prasadam, bhog chadao, and go. And you eat at your home. So that there is not overexposure to this energy. But nowadays, you will see that at most of the places, the mandirs are open for the overnight, 24 hours and so on. And people, the working there, they are overexposed to this energy, including the pandits. So naturally, they are going to have heart blocks, depression. My studies on Pandharpur also, I have said that Pandharpur Mandir is only on the water, mostly. All water veins going through. And all there, if you see the people, those who are worshipping Vithala, they are years and years old. All their children are into depressions. Or they are into aggressions. Let's go ahead. I can talk many things on this. Austria and Germany, the schools, buildings and colleges are being recommended to have a pre-survey before construction that this land do not have a geopathic stress, or the management of geopathic stress has to be done. It is recommended there in Austria and Germany. There are many scientists who have worked on this, Von Paul, Cathay Bachelor, Rolf Garden, and so many researchers have done a lot of work onto this. The basically what they have proved that this energy lowers down your immune system. Once your immune system is lowered down, you are more exposed to all types of infections, all types of conditions which can cause you ill health. I'm coming to a very interesting part now. Everybody must be now thinking that is my house affected by geopathic stress? Or am I affected by geopathic stress? I will just give you some guidelines or pointers. If a person has got serious illness like cancer, heart problems, depression, or many terminal conditions, kidney failures or anything, you can certainly think about a geopathic stress scanning of his house. A person having tried number different types of therapies having no results can definitely think about the geopathic stress under his bed. A person feels when he is away from home, much better in his health than when he comes back to home. once you are the tour for 10 days, if you feel better when you are out, and once you come back, you are having the same symptoms, you can certainly think about geopathic stress. He feels unrefreshed in the morning. If you are a geopathic stress person, you will feel that you are unrefreshed. You will feel that you are not having complete sleep. There will be a laziness in your activities, sluggishness everywhere, which are the first symptoms. You will find weakness. Some people will suggest to you that go for some electoral powder. Some people will tell you that you go for some combi flam like things, but that will not work for a longer time. It will give you just a symptomatic relief, but again you will come back to the normal or with the geopathic stress symptoms once you are on the geopathic stress. So these are very common things. If anybody is showing this type of symptoms, he can certainly think about the geopathic stress. I can give you some pointers whether my house is also affected by geopathic stress or not. If your house is having molds, lichens and moss and a dampness in your house, if your flooring is very, very cool, you can certainly think about geopathic stress. There may be a problem of ants, bees, cats and snakes also. My observation is this, that geopathic will attract all this small insects. If anyone is having termite problem, then he can certainly think about geopathic stress, because termite can grow only on geopathic stress. If there is this Brahmanda is prepared by Bhagwan in such a way that no energy is good or bad. Some energies are good for us and some energies are bad for some other animals, whereas some energies are bad for us, but they are very good for some animals. Amongst that geopathic stress, above 100, you will find that termites only grow on this energy. If anybody is having termite problem in his house anytime, he can certainly think about geopathic stress, because it requires 100 and above geopathic stress in their life cycle to grow. If anybody is having bees, hives in his balcony or somewhere near to his courtyard, he can certainly think about geopathic stress. If you feel that there is lot of or one or two cats are also in your courtyard and coming regularly to your place, you can think about geopathic stress. Snakes are attracted to your geopathic stress. Ants are also with geopathic stress. But dogs are not comfortable on geopathic stress. Horses are not comfortable on geopathic stress. Cows are not comfortable on geopathic stress. They avoid geopathic stress. They don't sit on geopathic stress anytime. They can feel that energy. If anyone is having a underground water level which is very near to the ground, some people tell me that, sir, we have a well or a boring where the water is just around 30 feet below or 50 feet. One can certainly think about geopathic stress, because the nearer the water to your surface of earth, you are more likely to get affected with geopathic stress. The presence on the cracks of the wall, presence of the trees with cancer lobes. We have all seen that when we travel on the highways, we see that the trees with some type of tumors on the stem of that, on the trunk of that. And these are all the indications of presence of geopathic stress. If you see some plant or some flowering plant or some fruit bearing plants which are having fruits at one side very largely with fruits, and other side is very low quantity of fruits, you can certainly think about geopathic stress. If your neighbor is in poor health, you can think about that same line, water line, same geopathic stress line can be crossing below my bed also. I have checked many buildings in Mumbai and many places where all the floors, 7 floors of the buildings are being affected with geopathic stress, and everywhere there is a patient. And lastly, that if you have taken a second-hand house, you are the second occupant of that house, and the first one also having some serious illness, then you can think about the geopathic stress maybe there in this house. How common it is? It is very common now. This presentation which I have prepared in 2005, I have given 30%, but now with the advent of use of more water, underground water, by day to day by us, the more we are using the underground water, there is more a running water vents activity. And the more running water vein activity is there, it is bound to cause us problem. How to treat it? You can also move out of geopathic stress, block the geopathic stress, or neutralize the geopathic stress. There are many methods by which we do this. We can attenuate the geopathic stress also. I'm coming to the last point here. Very important, geopathic stress and children. You will find there is an ADD syndrome. ADD is attention deficiency disorder. If you see a children with ADD syndrome who is very hyperactive, the parents are almost worried about his hyperactivity, he is not controlled by them, then you can definitely think about he is being on the geopathic stress. If he is having a bed waiting problem, I have a patient at the age of 11 to 12, male and girls also, they are doing bed wetting because they are on geopathic stress. The moment you do the treatment of geopathic stress, their bed wetting will stop. They will have insomnia. They will move like a you can see the clocks. How the clock needles, they move the same way. You will see that children, they move in the night on the bed if they are on geopathic stress. There is a cramp, increase in their heart rate. They avoid certain part of the bed. They may be in between the parents in the night, but some morning when you will find that they are somewhere at different place of the bed, one corner of the bed, to avoid the geopathic stress. They become lazy, moody, hostile, or sometimes aggressive and antisocial also. If they are missing the school because of the illness than the average children, we can certainly think about they are being geopathically stressed. If they are on geopathic stress, then we may have this problem more. WHO has given one synonymous to this type of buildings, which is known as sick building syndrome, which is known as SBS. If there is, you must have come across many such type of buildings where people do not like to work, not like to stay in these vastus for a longer time. There is always some headache to these patients, tension between the staff, lethargy, dry skin, loss of concentration, depression, stress, fatigue. And that all leading to the high absenteeism on the work. So working hours get affected. It's a waste of the human resource. If it is happening in certain top part of the building, we can certainly think about the geopathic stress on this. There is some energy which is affecting our people. There are many researches, as I told you, that Dr. Hanger has done some check. 543 patient who died with the cancer, and found that the cases are on the geopathic stress lines. Even Dr. Nipper has done 92% of the patients which are on geopathic stress. Hartman, in fact, he says that cancer is a disease of location. He's an MD physician. He says that cancer is a disease of location. The unfortunate part of this energy is that once it is generated from below the earth, it travels 60 kilometers above. So whether you are staying on the ground floor or you are staying at 21 floor number of floors, it makes no difference. I have a patients who are staying at around 20 floors or so on, but still they are having lung cancer patient symptoms. And that is why Hartman has said that cancer is a disease of location. Where you stay is very important for your health. Once your body is in stress, your irritability will increase. All your normal body functions will get disturbed. Your behavior will increase, will change. And this all things will lead you to the problems. My sincere request to each one of you that get your house checked timely for geopathic stress. And if it is there, please attenuate it. Please stop it so that the further damages to your houses or your near ones, your dear ones, we can take care of that. I think my time is coming to an end. If anyone has got some questions, I have kept for about 5 minutes to 10 minutes for them so that I can answer to them. If you have this type of system, then it is okay.
Yes, sir.
If anybody wants to ask any questions, he is welcome here.
I request my faculty members, if anybody is having any questions, any queries, you can ask.
Can I close the presentations?
Yes, sir. It was very nice, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.